So the idea that fat and cholesterol cause heart disease comes from 1952 from the diet heart hypothesis. A hypothesis is not the truth. It has to be proven. To prove a hypothesis takes a long time. Science doesn't work fast. And while science was working on this hypothesis, the governments in the Western world have fully committed to it. The media touted a new breakthrough that this is the truth. And all sorts of commercial companies jumped on the bandwagon. Pharmaceutical industry is making billions on this hypothesis. Food industry is making billions. Medical industry is making billions. Western governments are making billions. It has been proven wrong for the last 30 years. But because our political and commercial machine has committed to this hypothesis, they work very hard not to allow the population to know the truth. That dietary cholesterol and animal fats have nothing to do with heart disease. Low blood cholesterol is dangerous, not high blood cholesterol. Old people who have high levels of cholesterol have 100% here, no dementia, no Alzheimer's disease. They're healthy, they're sprightly, and they look after themselves, these people. So when you start reducing blood cholesterol levels, you're putting brain under grave danger. Because brain has cell regeneration processes going on all the time. Cells in the brain do die, and they get replaced by newly born cells. These processes are very active. And these new baby cells need building materials to be made from. They have to be made from cholesterol, saturated fats, proteins, glyconutrients, and some other things, but a large percent is fat and cholesterol. And if the blood cholesterol is low, the brain is not getting enough to maintain its structure and to function properly. People with low blood cholesterol have aggressive personalities and poor self-control. Because in order to form memories in the brain, synapses have to be formed. The cells in the brain have long arms. They grow long arms to communicate with each other. And when the two arms of two cells come together, they have to do this. They have to create a synapse here and a synapse here, and they have to connect. Now, the synapses are almost exclusively made out of cholesterol and saturated fat. If your blood cholesterol is low, that is the only place your brain can get cholesterol from. It can manufacture some, but not enough. Then the brain can't form these synapses. So the cells cannot connect with each other. As a result, the person cannot create memories. And it is the short-term memory that suffers. The person might remember what happened in the childhood, because those synapses were formed in the childhood, but he doesn't remember what he had for breakfast, and where he put his car keys, and where he left his hat, or his shoes, or something else. The short-term memory is not being formed, because the brain doesn't have enough building materials, resources, to create memories. People with low blood cholesterol suffer from infections 3 times more, and they die from infections much more often than people with normal and high level of cholesterol. We cannot fight infections without cholesterol. Every cell, about 70% of every cell, are membranes. So you can do the calculations yourself. What percent of your body is actually cholesterol and saturated fat? It is more than 50%. You are made from cholesterol. It is a structural element of every cell in your body. And you are made from saturated fats. And because the cells in the body constantly die and get replaced by newly born cells, building materials are required to build those new baby cells from, to give birth to them. So our bodies require large amounts of cholesterol all the time for that process, and saturated fats as well. There are people in whom this factory in the liver is broken because they are too toxic or they have nutritional deficiencies. These people cannot handle stress. They have nervous breakdowns. Children, adults, these people, they fly off the handle, or they become aggressive, or they attack. And that is a part of any mental illness. In my experience, in order to heal people with multiple sclerosis, they must have at least 6 eggs a day. Lots of butter, lamb fat, beef fat, goose fat, duck fat. The fattiest bits, that is their food. Only then they recover, these people, because they need to rebuild their myelin. So when your factory in the liver is struggling and cannot produce enough cholesterol, it's a good idea to give it some help by eating high cholesterol foods. Which foods are rich in cholesterol? Cod liver oil provides fish oils. It provides a lot of vitamin D and vitamin A in the right proportions. But the richest part of it is cholesterol. It is very rich in cholesterol. And without doubt, that is the major immune-boosting part of cod liver oil. The more cholesterol you eat, the less your body has to work hard to produce it. The less cholesterol you eat, the more your body will produce to compensate. It will just have to work harder. In order to have children, we need sex hormones. In order to procreate. Every sex hormone is made from cholesterol. People who go on low-fat diets and reduce their blood cholesterol levels become infertile. They cannot produce children. We have an infertility epidemic in the Western world. Many couples can't produce children in the Western world. What these ladies and men need to do is eat cream every day, butter, eggs, fat, and they will have a child. How does healing happen in the human body with any wound? Whether you scratched your skin, whether you bit your tongue, or anything else happened to you, or you had surgery, so your tissues were cut. There are two partners in healing in the body. One is inflammation. The second one is repair. What is inflammation? The immune system comes there. Immune cells, they're like an army, like soldiers in an army. They kill the enemy, and they clean away the debris. They clean the site. Once the place is clean, the second partner comes in called repair. What does repair do? Repair, first and foremost, grows collagen. Remember, your body is made out of collagen to a large degree. This is the molecules that hold us together. It will grow collagen, a network of collagen, like a network of wires across that wound to seal it, like a bandage across that wound to seal it. What is an atherosclerosis? It's an inflammation out of control. What we human beings have invented? We invented processed carbohydrates. We invented things made out of sugar, flour, soya flour, and vegetable oils. All your breakfast cereals are poisons. Nobody should be eating them. Sugar is a poison, the most addictive substance in the world. Modern bread, pastries, pasta, all of these sort of things, what are they? They are processed carbohydrates. When these things come into your stomach, into your digestive system, they are pre-digested in the factories by the food industry. They require virtually no digestion. They get broken down very quickly, and they absorb in the form of molecules of glucose. Glucose is in our blood, but the human body controls it within certain limits because too high, too low can kill. It's dangerous. Glucose can be very, very damaging. Because every cell in the body has little doors on it, glucose itself cannot open those doors. Insulin is the key that opens these little doors and pushes the glucose into the cells. In normal amounts, the cells can use glucose for production of energy. Vast majority of the human body, the cells use fat for production of energy, actually. It's not glucose that produces energy for you, it's fat. If the person had sugar and this sort of thing only occasionally, insulin will be produced, it will remove all that excessive glucose out of your bloodstream into the cells will process it, and the body can cope. But what do people do? What do our children do from a very young age? They have a sugary breakfast cereal in the morning, then they eat sandwich for lunch, crisps in the middle, and they eat pasta in the evening, and lots of sweets, chocolates, and soft drinks in between. A bottle of Coca-Cola has 8 teaspoons of sugar in it, and it absorbs in seconds. It's pre-digested. Your digestive system has nothing to do with it. It just floods into your bloodstream. So if that situation continues day after day, week after week, year after year, the cells in the body say, well, I had enough. The way they say it is by destroying those little doors on their wall that insulin opens. They become insulin resistant. They stop responding to insulin, the cells. That is the beginning of diabetes. Insulin is a master fat storage hormone in the body. The person finishes up with a high level of insulin all the time. They store everything they eat as fat as a result. A piece of lettuce will go into your thighs. Apart of that, from that, there's another function that insulin does. When there is too much insulin in the bloodstream, inflammation is initiated in the body. But insulin will never allow it to stop, because insulin is a pro-inflammatory hormone. It causes inflammation in the body, and it will not allow it to stop. So the person finishes up in a pro-inflammatory state. Their body is constantly inflamed, every organ, everywhere. And that is the basis now we know, with our recent scientific studies, that is the basis for formation of cancer. Cancer is an inflammation. Formation of mental illness, these people are in pro-inflammatory state. Diabetes, obesity, and all the other degenerative diseases, pro-inflammatory state. Majority of the Western population are constantly in a pro-inflammatory state because of what they're eating. So the real cause of heart disease epidemic is sugar, bread, breakfast cereals, pasta, vegetable oils, biscuits, cakes, and other processed and soft drinks. Human body has not been designed to get such huge amounts of one particular molecule. If you eat carbohydrates in a natural state, the way Mother Nature gave them to us, raw fruit, raw vegetables, raw grains, they're very difficult to digest. In fact, they're indigestible for the human digestive system. And most carbohydrate that's in them is indigestible. It goes through us, it doesn't absorb, doesn't digest, finishes up in your bowel, where the microbes in your bowel work on it. They digest it, and they manufacture, they convert all those carbohydrates, more than 75-80% of them, into short-chain fatty acids, which are fully saturated fat. So when we eat natural plants in a natural state, we digest them as saturated fat. They absorb, they feed our immune system, they feed our brain, they support us between meals. Sugar is not a natural molecule, it isn't a natural substance. Because in order for the human body to metabolize one molecule of sugar, we need 56 molecules of magnesium. We need dozens of chromium, we need zinc, we need enzymes, we need proteins, we need fats. When we take a piece of fresh sugar cane or a piece of fresh sugar beet, analyze them in a laboratory, we find that indeed every molecule of sugar in these natural foods are equipped with 56 molecules of magnesium and all those molecules of chromium and zinc and enzymes and all the other things. So when we chew sugar cane as it is, we get it in a complex and it does us only good, it's healthy. But we don't do that, do we? We take sugar cane and sugar beet to a big factory, we take the sugar out of them, and we throw everything else away. And this sugar comes into your body like a villain, like a highway robber. It needs those 56 molecules of magnesium. Where are they going to come from? From your muscles, from your brain, from your heart, from your bones. And every one of those tissues will suffer and develop disease. Let's introduce you to the real cause of heart disease epidemic in the Western world. It isn't cholesterol, it isn't fats. It is metabolic syndrome. What is metabolic syndrome? High level of insulin in your blood. That is metabolic syndrome. In fact, I recommend to people never test your blood cholesterol. If your doctor suggests you, let's test your blood cholesterol, say, no, thank you. Whatever it is, that's good for me. These are the common side effects of statins. They're well known, but doctors wouldn't tell you about this. Heart failure through coenzyme Q10 deficiency. This is a chemical that every muscle in the body requires in large amounts. It cannot function. Muscles cannot function without this chemical, particularly the heart. Many wives of men who started taking statins tell me that his personality changed. He became cantankerous and difficult to live with. And that happens to women as well. Cooking oils and vegetable oils. They cause cancer, diabetes, neurological damage, and immune problems. Cause atherosclerosis and heart disease. This has been proven. They cause atherosclerosis and heart disease. They're not just associated, they actively cause it. That is why Mother Nature wisely locked these fats within the structure of plants. The lettuce leaves, the apples, nuts, oily seeds, and other plants. When we eat these plants in their fresh form, we get all of these polyunsaturated fatty acids in the right amount and in the right biochemical shape and form and they are good for us. But what do? We take all that plant matter to our big factories, we chop it up, and we subject them to high heat, to oxygen, to chemical solvents, to pressure, to all sorts of things. So all of these fragile polyunsaturated fatty acids get mutilated. They are chemically mutilated molecules which have no place in the human body. This is pollution, poisonous pollution coming into your body. Never ever buy these oils, never cook on them. And there is a big risk in eating out, because all our food in restaurants, takeaway meals, and everywhere else are cooked with these poisonous oils.